Hey, good evening, Sam. Welcome.
Good evening. Hello, everyone. Thank you very much for being here today. It's a very special day for us. It's not often that I announce the launch of a new creative initiative on behalf of Star Group. I've chosen to do that today primarily because of the special nature of what we are going to come up with. I was asked to share with you how the idea came, the idea of TED Talks. I don't think the idea came in an inspired moment. To be honest, the idea came out of a deep sense of angst that has captured the imaginations of a lot of us in the creative sector, in the television business in particular. Because there seems to be a narrative that has been building up over a period of time that while entertainment television should be only homogeneous, offer a kind of content, offer a kind of programming that will be able to hold people's attentions in the evening, because anything that is deeply creative, intense, and also intellectually stimulating could not be accepted by the people at home when they sit with their families in the evening and turn on entertainment television. And as someone who has spent almost his entire life, professional life, in the business of television, I find that deeply disturbing. I also find at some level that to be very offensive, because isn't it only till recently that television emerged as the creative solution for ordinary people, people who could not engage on a daily basis with deep creative stimulation, could not engage with ideas, stories, what was happening around them in society, either at the personal level or at the level of community. Television was their only window to engage with that. And it troubles a lot of us, I'm sure it troubles a lot of you too, to think that television seems to be losing that space. And that doesn't have to be the case. And that is why at Star, every now and then we have focused our resources, energy, and our creative resources to come up with something that will challenge the established stereotypes, no matter how successful they might be, those stereotypes of creativity and content for entertainment television. And TED Talks on Star Plus is clearly an outcome of that. In the last few years, we've been thinking about it that, a very polarized perception seems to be developing that while the whole world is finding it easier to access ideas, access new thinking, access new and more exciting minds, all of that seems to be happening on the internet. And there was no better, in this whole cluttered world of the internet, there is probably no better place for those stimulus and those ideas and those minds to come together than on TED. I'm sure all of you here every now and then go and dig into the wisdom, excitement, stimulus, and intellectual curiosity that TED offers. And rightly as it calls its mission, ideas worth spreading. And if all those ideas worth spreading are abounding, yet for TED to make a distinct identity for itself in the whole cluttered world is something quite remarkable. And we were thinking that it would be at all possible to marry the ideas worth spreading, the intellectual uniqueness and distinctness of TED with our own mission of inspiring a billion imaginations at Star. And this was not an easy task. TED is something which is so unique, so pristine, and the uniqueness has been preserved so much, with so much, with so much care and attention. Also, in some ways, it also seems as if what TED offers was also an outcome of what regular television or print media do not offer, you know, or had left a gap in offering. And so we thought, if at all it was possible for Star to step into that space and work with TED to bring all those ideas worth spreading and make it accessible to a whole group of people who did not have easy access to that idea. Because regardless of the power and popularity of TED, there was one thing that was not happening, that people who could not consume content, appreciate content in English language, and who were not globally connected with the network of intellectual stimuli, were left out of the benefit that they could gain from TED. And that is why we thought, if we could persuade the TED team, led by Chris Anderson and Juliet, to consider what we were proposing to do, and it was not easy, but I have to say that it is the remarkable vision and social commitment of Chris Anderson and his whole team that we could, they were finally open to the idea. It took some time, took a long time to convince Juliet and Chris, but of course, all big beginnings take time and patience and effort. But we are happy that we were finally able to persuade them to consider the idea, and here we are today with probably the most exciting breakout creative proposition on mainstream television that has happened not just in India, but anywhere in the world in a very long time. And that is what makes it so exciting for us. It's been a labor of love. It's been in the making for a few years, from the ideation to engagement to conception and to execution finally. But when we started, when we decided TED and Star Plus, when we decided to come together, the first challenge was who will carry the baton for this? Who will be the public face? Who will present it to people? Who will take it to the potential viewers of Star Plus? Who will introduce the idea to them? It was not an easy task. We needed someone who could cut through the clutter, of course. We needed someone who had a distinct identity. However, it was not an easy thing for someone to be able to do that job with any degree of success and credibility among viewers. The person had to have a known intellect. The person had to have the range of intellectual richness that does not easily come to anybody. We also realized that the person really had to get excited about the power of idea before we could make the power of idea come alive on Star Plus. And when we started engaging with that whole challenge, the list turned out to be really short, with just one name on it. None other than the superstar of superstars, Shah Rukh Khan. He's the only person probably who, in his personal life, many of us have seen and encountered, really epitomizes the intellectual and creative curiosity that goes way beyond what he does on a daily basis. He's someone I've seen who's always excited about something new, something very different, no matter how unrelated or how irrelevant that might sound to that moment's engagement. And that's why when we went to Shah Rukh, we made this pitch, and it was the easiest conversation I've ever had with Shah Rukh Khan when he got me a drink, and before I could finish my first drink, he had signed on. So there we are with the TED team, Chris, Juliet, and Shah Rukh. We bring to you on Star Plus TED Talks India. You should just keep one thing in mind that the scale of the achievement as it is, before the show has begun, before we have launched the show, we are already very satisfied with one thing, that to bring an idea as eclectic, as diverse, and as intense as this on television in a language which is, even in this country, not usually considered the language of mass communication for intellectual ideas. We all seem to have a tendency that whenever we want to engage in a deep intellectual cerebral conversation, we try and resort to an alien language. But we're proud to bring it to you in Hindi. Thank you very much. Hopefully, you will like what we are going to show. Thanks.
Namaskar. Mera naam Chris hai. And yep, that's pretty much the limit of the Hindi that I remember. Even though, you know, my formative childhood years were spent here in India. I went to a school in the beautiful hill station, Mussoorie, up in the Himalayas. And I guess they taught us in English. We never really got fluent in Hindi. But this country really became, I would say, a key part of my identity. For example, in 1967, at the age of 10, when I took a trip back to England, the Indian cricket team came on tour, and I found myself, of course, cheering for India. My heroes back then were Bishan Bedi and Chandrasekhar with his googlies, and the swashbuckling opener, Farooq Engineer, and of course the heroic captain, the Nawab of Pataudi. You know, supporting India back then was a little harder than now because they pretty much lost every match. But in the years since then, I have watched in awe and admiration as both the country's cricketers and the country itself has grown in confidence and accomplishment to become the world power that it is today. So I guess I really mean it when I say I'm thrilled to be here this evening. For this launch, this is putting together the platform I've been trying to build for the last 16 years and bring it to a country that I feel such deep ties for. I mean, I really believe that TED and India are a match made in heaven. You know, some years ago, I had a conversation on a visit here that I'll never forget. It was with the visionary co-founder of Infosys, Nandan Nilekani. You know, I've been asking him how, given India's vast population, how on earth is it going to deal with some of the challenges it faces? He said to me, Chris, you're thinking of India as having more than a billion mouths to feed. I think of it as having more than a billion minds to deploy. Those minds are our greatest asset. What happens to them is going to determine our future. A powerful idea enters a mind. A miracle happens. That mind gets literally rewired just a little. Something that it didn't understand before, it now understands. It may perceive new possibilities that it didn't perceive before. The owner of that mind may feel inspired to dare greater things for her life than she ever dared before.
Thank you very much, and a very good evening to you. Namaskar and assalamu alaikum to all of you present here. Main zyada waqt nahi lunga aap logon ka, do teen baatein karunga bas, aur phir uske baad I think we'll open to the press to ask us about TED Talks India, Nayi Soch. First of all, why TED Talks? And bachpan mein mujhe malum nahi kaise ye hua, lekin ऐसा कुछ हुआ कि मेरे माँ बाप ने या टीचर्स ने या दोस्तों ने या जो मोहल्ले वाले हैं उन सब लोगों ने कुछ ऐसा कुछ सिखाया मुझे कि मुझे जानने की इच्छा बहुत ज़्यादा हो गई हर चीज़ में. सो लाइक क्यूरियस जॉर्ज और द क्यूरियस कैट, आई वॉन्ट टू नो एवरीथिंग. मुझे बड़ी तकलीफ़ होती है अगर कोई चीज़ या कोई शब्द मुझे बोला जाए और मुझे उसका मायने ना आता हो या उसकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग ना हो. मोर ऑफन देन नॉट, बिकॉज आई एम एन एक्टर, व्हेन पीपल से समथिंग दैट आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड और नो अबाउट, आई जस्ट एक्ट आउट दैट आई हैव अंडरस्टूड बाय बिहेविंग लाइक ऑफ कोर्स लॉट ऑफ वर्ड्स दैट उदय स्पीक्स जस्ट बिफोर वी डिड, लाइक एक्लेक्टिक आई स्टिल डोंट अंडरस्टैंड, बट बैक देयर आई केप्ट ऑन गोइंग दिस इज अ वेरी एक्लेक्टिक शो. या आई अंडरस्टैंड. So I've been doing that all my life. But the only good habit I have is as soon as I find out something I don't know, even before the times of Google, when we used to look for words in the dictionary, or if we were well-to-do enough, had an encyclopedia at home, I would rush home and try to understand, ask my father, ask my mother, ask my teachers. And the only thing else that I could ask was TED Talks. And that time, TED Talks wasn't available like it is now on the digital medium, and now, inshallah, on television very, very soon. But I was a big, big fan of TED Talks. And that's why कि हमेशा वो जवाब मुझे मिलता था जो मैं पूछना चाह रहा था सवाल बट उन लोगों की बातें जो मर्द और औरत वहाँ पे आके बातें करते थे उनसे कुछ ना कुछ मुझे समझने को सीखने को मिलता था फॉर इयर्स आई फॉलो टेड टॉक्स एंड स्पेशली व्हेन द वर्ल्ड वाइड वेब केम अराउंड इवन इन द डेज विद दैट ओल्ड मॉडेम वी फॉरगॉटन दोज डेज नाउ वी जस्ट क्लिक ऑन समथिंग इट हैपेंस The world has moved on so much, but the only thing that hasn't changed for me is that I still look forward to hearing a TED talk, whichever's happening anywhere in the world. Juliet, for allowing me to be a part of TED Talks recently when they called me over to Vancouver. It is perhaps, if I may say, the most eclectic, intellectual, wonderful gathering that I've ever been in the world. And perhaps the greatest achievement of my whole career and actually my whole 52 years of life. So thank you so much, Chris. And thank you, Juliet, for calling me there. I was extremely nervous. I didn't know how to speak there, being an actor, professional actor for 30 years. But to go and speak in front of some of the best minds, and not the best minds because they have a collection of the greatest of scientists, innovators, inventors, no. The best minds, because they have the simplest idea, the smallest idea, and they're willing to share it with the world because I truly believe the world changes by the smallest of ideas. I hear a lot of people who talk about world domination and taking over and doing this and changing the face. No, I think all changes that take place in the world, in life, anywhere in the universe, I think, is because of a small idea. And I think the bigness of TED Talks lies in the fact that it gives a huge platform to the smallest of ideas. So for me to be on this platform as a host, as an anchor, I don't even know what we'll call it that once the show comes on air. I want to thank the other gentleman who came on stage before me, that is Mr. Uday Shankar. So thank you so much, sir, kahan pe aap, for allowing me to be standing here. And thank you for taking this one big step. In the times when we are trying to take everything onto the digital world, why, pray, are we trying to bring stuff back on television? Is that a step backward? I don't think so. The main essence of that is the language part of it. Mujhe aisa lagta hai, jo Uday saab ne bhi kaha, ki hum log, kahin na kahin par hamari apni bhasha, अब हमारी भाषा थोड़ी मिक्स हो चुकी है मतलब हिंदुस्तानी सी हो गई है इंग्लिश भी है उसमें हिंदी भी है स्पोकन जो भाषा है वो इजी हो गई है लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं पर हमारी भाषा के अंदर इंटेलेक्चुअलिज्म जो है मैं ये नहीं कहूँगा एक्सेप्टेबल नहीं है मुझे कभी कभी लगता है समझ भी नहीं आता है क्योंकि इतने भारी भरकम वर्ड होते हैं एक एंटरटेनमेंट चैनल को ये स्टेप लेने के लिए सॉरी क्रिस एंड जूलियट आई एम जस्ट सेइंग गुड थिंग्स अबाउट यू व्हेन आई एम स्पीकिंग इन इंडिया सो डोंट आई एम स्टिल प्रेजिंग यू ओके सो मैं अगर प्रेज नहीं भी कर रहा हूँ तो बीच में मैं बोलता रहूँगा जूलियट क्रिस एक बार तालियां बजा दो सी आई डिडंट से एनीथिंग गुड अबाउट यू जस्ट मेड देम क्लैप दैट्स सो लाइक आई वाज सेइंग द फैक्ट एन एंटरटेनमेंट चैनल लाइक स्टार दे डू सम वंडरफुल जर्नल एंटरटेनमेंट प्रोग्राम्स एंड दे हैव ऑल काइंड ऑफ सीरीज एंड आई थिंक इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेक एंड आई एम नॉट सेइंग वन ऑफ द ओनली वंस मेनी इयर्स अगो आई रिमेंबर उदय साहब मेट मी एंड ही स्टार्टेड अ प्रोग्राम कॉल्ड सत्यमेव जयते I think that was the step in the right direction. You take issues, you take things that are happening in our country and present it to the country, men and women, so they understand and perhaps come up with solutions for the same. Aur isliye mujhe aisa lagta hai ki Star pe TED Talks India nayi soch ka aana bahut ahem baat hai. Wo isliye ki wo hamari bhasha mein hogi. Wo ek aisa platform hoga jahan pe hamare deshvasi, hamare hindustani log, mard aur aurte aur jawan log A country which perhaps is the youngest, actually is the youngest country in the world, gives you an opportunity, a stage, a platform, giving an opportunity to our youngsters to come and share ideas, small ideas, which will change not only our country, but hopefully the rest of the world too, for the better. Aur aakhri baat main sirf ye kehna chahunga ki main isme kya kar raha hu aur main isme kyun hu. Main isliye hu because I don't think I could have gotten an opportunity. I've been working for 30 years as an actor, a movie star. I sing, I dance, I fall, I fight, I romance, I emote, I do everything. But there's very seldom I'm able to show, nudify myself for who I am and come in front of people on a platform and say, this is who I actually am. This is who I am as a father, as a husband, as a friend, as just a normal guy who came from Delhi 30 years ago to make a living in Mumbai and has done rather well for himself. But who am I? I think TED Talks India, Nayi Soch, gives me that platform just to be me. And unashamedly so, happily so, eclectically so, intellectually so, smartly so, happily so, and in every which way possible, perhaps one of the most satisfying, if I may call it, jobs that I've done in my whole career. So thank you, Uday. Thank you, Star. Thank you, everyone in this country, to give me this opportunity. One last thing, I have started feeling lately since I've turned 50 that it has become much easier in this world now to hate, to be blatantly aggressive, to put your thought out there because I think so. And it's very nice. Maybe it'll bring about a great change in the world. Maybe picking up cudgels, walking down the roads, getting angry with each other, having spats, abusing. Maybe. That's the way the directness of it all is going to change the world. But I truly believe that in this rush, in this hoard, is bhagam dod mein, nafrat karne mein, gussa karne mein, hum log pyar ko bhul gaye. And I genuinely would like to claim today that I am not just the best lover in the world as I've shown myself in the films, I am love itself. I truly believe in the power of love. And love is nurtured by ideas, small, simple ideas. Warmth of ideas, goodness of ideas, kindness of ideas, just believing in a simple thing that you want to believe in. And I think TED Talks India, TED Talks itself for years, has just been doing that. It has been spreading ideas, simple ideas to the rest of the world. As a matter of fact, unwittingly, unknowingly, this is a platform which will somehow spread love when it gives opportunities to people to come and discuss things that they always believe in, feel for, but have never thought it's good enough to be spread to the world or shared with the world. So I thank you all for being here. When the show comes out, I hope you all like it, because Star does stand for entertainment too. We are not taking that away from the show. It's a difficult mix. Bahut mushkil hai ki entertaining platform bhi bana ke rakhe, usko intellectual bhi rakhe, usko inspiring bhi rakhe, usko khushal bhi rakhe, usko acha bhi rakhe. तो हमारी बहुत मेहनत गई है इसके अंदर, हमने बहुत कोशिश की है और हमें ऐसा लगता है कि मेरी कोशिश या क्रिस की कोशिश या उदय साहब की कोशिश या स्टार टीम की कोशिश की वजह से नहीं, जस्ट बिकॉज ये थॉट अच्छा है, आप लोगों को ये सुनना और जानना अच्छा लगेगा, शायद इसलिए ये एंटरटेनिंग भी होगा. सो आई होप फॉर द बेस्ट फॉर द प्रोग्राम. आई थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम. आई एम सॉरी, आई थिंक आई हैव स्पोकन लॉन्गर देन आई शुड, बट वंस अगेन गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल फॉर बीइंग हियर. वंस अगेन थैंक यू क्रिस फॉर मेकिंग मी अ पार्ट ऑफ दिस. Thank you, Uday, for making me a part of this and paying me so much money for the IPL franchise too. That helps. Some more new shoes and some new cooler clothes. I mean, I have a better car than Uday now, so that's... And thank you, Juliet. Thank you, Gaurav. Thank you, everybody. Some of the men and women who have worked hard for this in the production part of it, who are backstage right now. Thank you, Star Plus. Thank you, Star. And thank you, all of you, for being here. I hope you all have a good evening and a good life and take away some good ideas. And I will take one moment now to call upon the two men who are actually responsible for this. Me, as usual, will take the credit. When the show comes out, everybody will say, kya yaar, Shah Rukh ne kya kaam kiya, kamal kar diya yaar, maza aaya, kya baat hai yaar. Sirf Shah Rukh kar sakta na, he's beautiful, he's handsome, he's intellectual, he's so sexy. So all the credit I will take away. But the two men and the people behind who have actually made this happen, I'd like to call them back on stage. So the biggest round of applause for Chris and Uday Saab. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you so much. Mr. Shah Rukh Khan, as you rightly said, indeed your love itself and kuch kuch hota hai. Thank you so much. Pleasure to have you here. Thank you. May I request you to please be seated. Sawal jawab ka silsila shuru karne wale hain, jiske liye main manch par bulana chahunga, Star India ke president and head of content studio, Mr. Gaurav Banerjee ko bhi. और उनके साथ हेड ऑफ टेलीविजन क्यूरेटर स्पेशल प्रोजेक्ट्स टेड टॉक्स जूलियट ब्लेक जिन्होंने महीनों की कड़ी मेहनत से इस शो को साकार किया है. वेलकम एवरीवन. बिफोर वी ओपन द फ्लोर फॉर द क्यू एंड ए आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क जूलियट अ क्वेश्चन. जूलियट वेलकम.
थैंक यू.
यू नो what has been your experience of putting this show together?
Well, it's been the best. I've made over 200 hours of television in my choti si zindagi, and this has been the best experience in my entire life. You can imagine, as somebody from England living in New York, making television, working in Hindi was a challenge. But the team at Fremantle and the team, well, Gaurav and Manisha and everybody at Star Plus, have made it the best experience of my working life. And I'm so proud of the speakers that we have on the program and of the entertainment value of the program. And when you look at the audience, they are so wrapped, enwrapped on the shows. If there's a talk that's very meaningful, sometimes the audience are in tears. Other times they're laughing. It felt like such a deep connection between the people standing in the middle of the red circle, speaking, giving a TED talk for the very first time, and the audience really so immersed. And of course, the big treat was working with Shah Rukh. Of course it was. It was amazing. And he is not only intellectual and brilliant, he asked the best questions of our speakers. Of course, we prepared him a few questions, but he never used them. He went completely from his own brain. And he's a very clever man, and we're very blessed to have him as our host.
Thank you so much, and we look forward to it. Thank you so much. And as Shah Rukh Khan always brilliantly does it, India also welcomes you the similar way with open arms. Thank you so much. And ladies and gentlemen, now the...
Okay, thank you for the question, Sana. I will leave you with some intrigue. You know what TED Talks are like. So you heard in depth Chris's vision for TED. And that was our starting point. When I met with Chris, when I read his book, he talks about spreading ideas and the power of ideas. And that's how essentially civilization started, around a campfire, telling stories. So we want to capture that. We hope to capture that. Hopefully, as Shah Rukh Sahab was saying, you will find something new in the kind of mix that we are trying to create. That yes, there should be ideas, there should be fun, and we definitely at Star Plus believe that entertainment can be interesting and intelligent.
And what is the time slot that you're looking forward for?
Wait to hear more from us. We'll tell you.
Hi, Shah Rukh.
Hi.
Shah Rukh, ek chota sa idea kuch bhi badal sakta hai, jaisa ki aapne bhi kaha. तो कभी ऐसा कोई आइडिया आपके दिमाग में आया जो आपने किसी के सामने पुट अप किया हो और वो तुरंत रिजेक्ट हो गया हो, पर बाद में उस पर आपने काम किया और वो सक्सेसफुल हुआ?
हेलो हेलो. हाँ, ये इंटरनेट का आइडिया मेरा ही था. मैं सच बता रहा हूँ. मैं, आप लोग नहीं मानोगे इस बात को यार, आप लोग हंस रहे हो यार. अरे, शी जस्ट आस्क्ड मी इज देयर एन आइडिया दैट यू हैड एंड व्हिच यू प्रेजेंटेड टू पीपल and they rejected it, and now it's done well. So I explained to her, the internet was my idea.
How?
And genuinely bata raha hu, magar chote-chote ideas, aise reject to nahi hue, lekin of course, many a times, mujhko aisa laga, ki maine khul ke logon ko bataya nahi. You know, many a times I've had some ideas, I'm sure all of us have had this, on the dais here and everyone there amidst you. We've always get some good idea, and then we are kind of shy. Sometimes we just keep it to ourselves that people may not like it or not enjoy it or it's not good enough. And then you realize after some years that whatever ideas you had, good, bad, ugly, small, little, black, white, red, green, they all have a place in the sun. All you need to do is express it. And I think that is what TED Talks Nayi Soch and TED Talks has been doing for years. And I think that's the encouragement we want to do. But there have been many a times that I've had ideas. A lot of times I've given the idea, it's been accepted and failed miserably. Many times I've had an idea not shared and seen it elsewhere and felt really, really disturbed and stupid. And yes, sometimes I have given an idea that's got accepted and a lot of other people have accepted too in my line of work.
और एक चीज़ और जानना चाहेंगे, इस शो के कितने एपिसोड्स रहेंगे?
मुझसे बताया गया है मुझको कि जो भी टेक्निकल सवाल होगा वो मैं गौरव की तरह पॉइंट करूँगा तो गौरव विल टेल यू
या गौरव
तो कुछ कुछ होता है हमने कुछ कुछ रिकॉर्ड किया है और हम बहुत कुछ करना चाहते हैं
हाय खान साहब आपके स्ट्रीट देख सके खान साहब आलोक दिस साइड होस्ट करना आपके लिए कोई नई बात नहीं है आपने अवार्ड शोज होस्ट किए हैं बहुत सारे टीवी शोज भी होस्ट किए हैं जब टेड की बात आई तो आपके जहन में क्या चला और आपको क्या लगा कि भारतीय सिस्टम के हिसाब से आप किस तरीके से इसे होस्ट करने वाले
एक्चुअली सबसे जो कम काम है ऐसे शोज़ में वो होस्ट का होता है और शायद इसलिए ही सबसे ज़्यादा अहम काम भी हो जाता है मैं मूवी स्टार हूँ लाइक यू सेड मैंने बहुत सारे प्रोग्राम्स होस्ट किए हैं the dancing shows I've done I think all my shows with the star before this whether it's Panchvi Pass whether it's even KBC for that matter I need to bring in loads of entertainment which is a part of my profession onto the stage so people don't get disappointed because I don't do the things that I'm supposed to do but I think TED Talks is I won't say difficult but extremely positively creatively challenging Like I said, कि मुझको अपने आप को पेश करना है मेरी जो अपनी जिज्ञासा है मेरा जो अपना दिल में है कि मैं क्या चीज़ को कैसे समझूँ Like Juliet said, when I'm talking to the people, they would give me questions, but listening to their talk, I would like to ask them something else, which perhaps you and I and everybody watching it at home on television when it gets transmitted, actually want to ask. So just to be on your toes, actually this is a show which has kept me more alive. Each show used to take some time to shoot. Say a couple of hours, but for those 2 hours, not once would I relent or take recourse to coming and dancing instead. I was here, I was listening, and I wanted to participate in the experiences of their life, and I think hopefully that will come through when I'm hosting it. So I'm not going to be pompous and say, oh, I've hosted X, Y, Z. I just hope I'm able to enhance the ideas, the thoughts, the talks that people have there on this show and become part of it. I think that's the new thing for me. And creatively challenging and personally very satisfying
khan sahab khabar ye bhi hai ki aap ted book mein bhi likhne wale hain ted ki jo kitab hai uske liye aapko likhne ki shuruaat to aapne kar di hai kuch thoughts hain kis tarike se
no I haven't I think juliet and chris have been more than gracious in every which way as far as ted talks is concerned and yes it's a very proud moment for me when they requested me to do this or asked me if I could do it but I haven't started working on it yet I'm going to work on it I even for my speech which I gave at TED Talks Chris and Juliet were very hands on helping me all over the emails again and again and telling me what is right what is wrong how I should say it even on stage I joked about it but sincerely so they were very very helpful and extremely encouraging so hopefully when I get down to writing I'll more than my time I have to take their time and as always just take the credit afterwards
khan sahab videsh ke format se kitna alag hone wala kyunki abhi humne sangeet bhi suna dekha to thoda agar zikr kare aap
this is the first time ted talks is going to be on television anywhere in the world ye kahin kabhi bhi nahi aaya hai तो ऑब्वियसली कोई गिवन फॉर्मेट नहीं है देर इज़ नो फॉर्मेट दैट इज एग्जिस्टिंग ऑन टेलीविजन ऑफ टेड टॉक्स यू शुड ऑल आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन एंड इम्प्लोर एवरीवन टू प्लीज इफ यू हैवन सीन टेड टॉक्स प्लीज टू गो ऑन द नेट गो टू टेड टॉक्स डॉट कॉम वॉच इट एंड यूल अंडरस्टैंड इट्स अबाउट टॉकिंग एंड शेयरिंग आइडियाज विद पीपल एंड ऑफकोर्स फॉर टेलीविजन स्टार बींग सो इनोवेटिव गौरव स्टीम बींग सो इनोवेटिव सम न्यू थाट्स हैव कम बट रिटेनिंग absolutely retaining the authentic quality of TED Talks and the intellect and the goodness of it so that it doesn't waver from what TED Talks has created itself and when Uday has taken it onto the television. So there is no taking away from the program, retain the same qualities and somehow add some new thing to it, which will be very subtle and I think very interesting how they've done it.
Hi, Ankur from Huffington Post here. My question is for Chris. Chris, traditionally, Indian television is not particularly known for, you know, having super intelligent content. Do you think this show could probably shift that image? And if you think so, what actually made you explore India as a market for this particular show?
There are more than a billion minds in India and growing, continuing to grow fast. That, as Nanda Nilekani said, is the world's most amazing asset. And every time I've been to India in my time here, I've just been stunned at how much hunger there is for knowledge, for education at one level, for, you know, how can I know more and what can I do with that knowledge? So this is not TED coming to India and saying, hey, let's bring some ideas and see what happens here. It's actually the opposite of that. It's saying, wow, what an opportunity there is here. There is so many brilliant people here. If we could unlock their thinking, it's not only about sharing it in India, it's carrying these ideas to the rest of the world. Some of the talks that I've seen, I cannot wait to take to a broader global platform. So I really can't state strongly enough how big a deal this is for TED. This is by far the biggest partnership we've ever done with another media partner. We've never done a show like this. TED used to be once a year, 800 people in California. To have a chance to reach literally millions of people in what soon will be the world's most populous country, wow, that is the most exciting thing. We couldn't be more pumped about it.
Just to add to that, and Uday, I would also like your sort of perspective on it. What kind of a say do you have on the guests that come on the show? Because internationally, you learn everything about astrophysics to the refugee crisis, the video that TED does. So how much will it deviate from, you know, the standard fare that we're used to seeing? Because we hear that Karan Johar and Javed Akhtar, mostly Bollywood people are the guests so far. So will we see other people from different spheres of life as well?
There's a huge variety of speakers. You know, see, people sometimes think about ideas the wrong way. Ideas are everything from the incredible invention, the light bulb moment, right through to just a simple human insight about how to live your life better. TED is interested in all of these ideas, and you'll see the full panoply on this program.
Shahrukh? Hello. Hi, I'm Nikita from Free Press Journal. I just had a question. This is a program or a platform where people talk about ideas. So from you, I want to know any word or any idea that really stuck in your mind or changed you as a person or your life.
Any idea that is stuck
any
in my...
Any idea or a word, like you were hung over the word eclectic a while ago. So anything on that regards.
Top of the head, I can talk just related to my work, honestly. I have some ideas which I have stuck in my head for the last 4 or 5 years about the kind of film that I would like to produce next. But I've still not been able to do it.
Anything in the personal regards as a person, as a personality, in you, as self, anything somebody said to you that got a change in you?
One of the ideas is to start shooting shifts later, which I'm still trying to promote, even though it's not legal, but I'm still coming late and making sure that one day they will change it, ki 2 baje ki shift rakho. But yeah, at a personal level, there are a lot of ideas. Maybe one day we sit down and chat over a cup of coffee or tea and discuss them. No, I'm full of ideas. I'm actually...
Always open for it.
The idea or the coffee?
Coffee.
Okay. We can do the ideas later, yeah.
Thank you.
Hi, Shahrukh.
Uday, sir. I'm this side. So I'm Nazia from Exchange for Media. So there's so much talk about ideas. I need some idea about the budget of the show.
That's a very good idea.
Some idea only. I'm not asking for the exact numbers. If we can have it.
Well, thank you very much for not asking for the exact numbers. I'm not going to give you the inexact number, except for the fact that you know that Star, we have always believed, that material resources should not dictate the quality of the creative product. We've gone and done this. It's a show that requires a lot of effort in terms of picking up the right kind of talent, picking up the right people to, you know, come on the show. Research is very, very deep, intensive. It's been in the making for a number of months. All of that has cost money. But when we are doing a show like this, really the money that we have spent on it becomes the least of the concerns.
Despite IVL bidding, you don't mind spending...
Sorry?
Mr. Khan, if I can ask you one question. We are a website about brands and advertising. You've been a brand relevant for 30 years now. How do you keep yourself going? As in, do big brands come to you for advice about, you know, how to be relevant for like 30 years? And inshallah for another 30 years.
No, that's very sweet of you to ask and assume that big brands come to me for advice. I think I'm fortunate enough because of the kind of work I've been related to. For example, the big brand of TED Talks and the big brand of Star giving me this opportunity. I think the only reason is I'm happy to try something new. I think if you want to be relevant as a brand, I really don't know about brand management and build up, but I think the only relevance that I can tell you about building a brand is if you are ready to try new things, if you are ready to fail, if you are ready to venture into territories that you don't know anything about. And some of them will go wrong, some of them will go right, and some of them will actually help you build your brand because it'll make it more edgy, new, innovative. I think that's the only thing I can say, that I'm ready to try new stuff. Given the platform as an actor that I've created, I'd really like to try new stuff. I just go for it and hope for the best and leave it genuinely to the experts that they will guide me and take their word for it. And as an actor, go ahead and do my job.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Hi, hello, Shahrukh. Hello, Shahrukh. My name is Sandeep, and I'm from tarichakka.com. Sandeep.
Sandeep. Hi, Sandeep.
Hi. You were very right when you said very few people are interested in having and becoming one with something psychological, intense, as TED Talks. So what is the audience that we are looking at?
Sorry?
You were very right when you said that people are not really looking forward to something very intellectual and psychological, especially when it goes beyond the level of understanding. So with TED Talks being something very intense, psychological and intellectual, what kind of audience are we looking at?
I think two things I'll say, Sandeep. Uh-huh. One, I truly believe as a person who's part of media like you guys are and girls are, I think we underrate our audience always. Uh-huh. I think we always start, this is an excuse. I think this is unreasonable to say people are not ready to accept. People are ready to accept if you put it out in the right spirit. Anything that is good, intellectual, entertaining, scientific, any kind of knowledge garbed in whichever method you want to. That's what I think every audience wants. I didn't mean to say sorry if it was misunderstood, people are not ready. I meant that perhaps we have, as media people, as thinkers, as innovators, not done enough to bring forth to the audience mm-hmm. what they are waiting for. So I think all kind of audience, especially the youngsters, will really like what we've tried to put up in TED Talks, India Nahi Soch. And the second part of it is, when we talk about ki intense hai, psychological hai, actually our lives are like that. Our lives are psychological.
Of course.
Our lives are intense. Our lives are entertaining. Our lives are knowledgeable and sometimes the opposite. So there's always a craving in all our hearts. All we need is someone to give it to us. So hopefully we'll be able to manage that. And I think whatever little I understand of a show like this, because I've watched it for years, I think we will manage to fulfill the craving a lot of people for a program like this.
I just one more question to you. Given a choice, given a chance, would you host a program like Big Boss?
I've done a lot of hosting here. I mean, there's no question of being host of X or Y or Z. I think all programs that all movie stars are hosting, they have some interesting thing to say in it. I've done lots of them myself. But I've never been really been approached for a show of that nature yet. So I don't know. If I'm free, then I'm willing. And if the money is good. Having said that, for TED Talks, I've not charged like all the other anchors are charging for other shows. This one is from the heart.
I just want to chip in. I just want to chip in one thing in what you said. You referred to TED as intellectual content. That's really not how we think of it. The mission of TED is to make ideas accessible. And I really think the way we think of it is that we are trying to go to what is the core human superpower, that what distinguishes us from other species on the planet is that we have this ability to picture the world in a different way than it is right now, and to share those pictures with each other by telling stories. A speaker can learn to make even difficult ideas vivid and exciting. That's the challenge, and that's the challenge we've set ourselves. So I don't think you should think of this as intellectual content. I think you should think of it as powerful content, mind content, inspiring content. That's the goal, certainly.
Thank you so much. I apologize to intervene, but that's all the time we have for the Q&A. Apologize, and thank you so much, everyone.
One last question.
Please.
Hello, hello.
I'll do that.
Hello.
I'll do that. Thank you.
Hi, Shahrukh. Thank you. Sana from Indian Express here. When we are talking about ideas recently at the launch of Big Boss, when we asked Salman that it would be a tough competition between you, Akshay, and Salman being on TV at the same time, he said that it would be a tough competition for you guys. So what is your idea on his idea? That it will be a tough competition for you and Akshay?
To be really honest, Salman and Akshay, what they're doing, they're in a league of their own. I'm not even competing with them right now. So they're doing wonderfully well. And I think it's sweet of Salman to say what he said. And it's really wonderful. Having said that, I'm not going to say that this show is so different that we're not competing on the platform. In no way do I want to be derisive of entertainment that they will provide on television through the respective shows they're doing. But I think this really is kind of a different platform where it has a different sensibility. It's a new thing, you know. I'm not saying this is old, has been done, been there, done that. I think it's wonderful what they're doing. I know Salman's doing Big Boss and Akshay's doing
the Great Indian Laughter Challenge.
I think this show is a little different from them. Does not make it better or worse, it's just different. I think this will be running in a lane of its own, not competing with anyone. And I'll just like to make this clear because, you know, when we talk about intellectualism and we talk about it being, it genuinely is an extremely hopeful and inspiring show. It'll have entertainment. It's not plugged in as trying to get an X amount of rating or 20 amount of audience. It genuinely is sharing a great idea. So it does have its own lane that it's running. It will be, you know, hopefully we'll be able to compete with ourselves. And what TED Talks has created over the years, what Star has done, what Gaurav has done, what everybody in this media has done before, hopefully we'll be able to just compete with ourselves and do our best. I think in this case, this show, we're just trying to compete with ourselves to give our best to us first, and then hopefully it'll transform into and transcend to all of you.
Salman, one last question this side.
I apologize to intervene.
One last question, Salman, this side. Sorry, Shahrukh, this side. Because you were talking about Salman.
I'm extremely sorry, but
what's your
name? Time constraint.
I don't know, where are you speaking from?
Shahrukh, this side.
Kaan ho, kaan aap?
Yahan, I'm literally sorry. Because, yeah, Lipika here. I'm literally sorry.
Don't worry, Deepika, it's all right.
Lipika.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Deepika. I'm extremely sorry. I'm so sorry.
Yeah. Okay, you said this one is from the heart. So do you mean to say that money does not keep you going anymore?
No, it never has. It never will. And I never, ever in my life. I'm very well-to-do. I think God has been very kind to me in every aspect of my life. Professionally, economically, financially, and more than that emotionally. But never ever have I done anything for the love of money. I'll say this to every youngsters who are hearing this. If you do something that you really desire and want to do, one of the things that will surely follow is money. Is the least important of the pegs that you should try to fill in when you're trying to do something as work, as a job, as love, as hobby. Money will always follow. Money is not going to be a problem at the end of it all. And I say it from the point of view of being a lower middle class boy who's had much more share of his financial benefits from the work I do than I ever imagined, dreamed of in the wildest of dreams. No, I have never done anything. And however people may believe, I'm an entrepreneur, I do businesses, X, Y, Z. I've never done anything for the liking or love of money. I do this because I love doing it. And this show, TED Talks India, Nai Soch, on Star, is perhaps the closest thing to my heart. And I'm not saying it because Uday is a friend and Chris and Juliet have been nice and Gaurav's a friend. I say it because I genuinely believe it. And I hope how much I love this, everybody else also loves it. It's important for me that this gets loved by everyone. Without any competition, without trying to compare, without any comparison to what the great star and Uday Saab have already achieved on television. No, it should just stand alone on its own and be loved for the love we are putting in. That's all.
Main maaf ye chahta hu. Waqt ki ahmiyat ko maddenazar rakhte hue, sawal jawab ka silsila khatam karna padega. I apologize.
From the three of you, if you're taking my name right. अच्छा अभी करना ना मुझे ओ हाँ लास्ट लास्ट सवाल है गुस्सा मत हो खफा मत हो तीन सवाल होंगे भाई मैं पैसे के लिए कुछ नहीं करता लेकिन तुझसे लूंगा
हेलो
बोल दे सुनाई दे रहा मुझे
शाहरुख मेरा सवाल आपसे ये है कि आपने हमेशा बताया है कि फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में दिलीप कुमार और अमिताभ बच्चन को देख करके आप बहुत इंस्पायर रहे हैं लेकिन अपार्ट फ्रॉम फिल्म इंडस्ट्री के लोगों को अगर कोई ऐसे कौन से लोग रहे हैं जब आप बड़े हो रहे थे तो उनको देख के आप इंस्पायर हुए और आपको लगा कि मैं इनकी तरह बनना चाहूँ हमेशा रहते हैं
उनकी तरह नहीं मिल्खा सिंह जी कैशियस क्ले मोहम्मद अली मदर टेरेसा उनकी तरह बन तो मैं कभी नहीं सकता लेकिन इनकी कहानियाँ सुन के मैं बहुत इंस्पायर हूँ मैं अभी भी पढ़ता हूँ और कुछ नाम है शायद जो मैं भूल गया हूँ टॉप ऑफ द हेड बट ये तीन चार लोग मेरे दिमाग पीटी उषा जी जब मैं बड़ा हो रहा था हमारी इंडियन हॉकी टीम उस ज़माने में भी और आज के ज़माने में भी मुझे बड़ी इंस्पायरिंग लगती है और सिर्फ इसलिए नहीं कि मैंने चक दे किया है जेन्युइनली मुझे वो नेशनल स्पोर्ट के अंदर मैं बहुत फॉलो करता था तो बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जिनको मैं पढ़ के सुन के वैसा बनना चाहता हूँ क्योंकि उनकी जो जिंदगियाँ हैं बड़ी सिंपल और छोटी सी थी काम उनके बड़े हो गए सो इसलिए मैं उनसे बहुत इंस्पायर होता हूँ थैंक यू सचिन
हेलो
फॉर लुकिंग आफ्टर अस
थैंक यू
आई एम सो सॉरी यार
शाहरुख
अच्छा सवाल पूछेगा अच्छा सवाल
अच्छा अच्छा या शाहरुख या हाय वी हैव बीन एडिक्टेड टू वॉचिंग टेड टॉक्स ऑलवेज ऑन द इंटरनेट व्हाट इज द एक्स्ट्रा प्रेशर ऑन यू फॉर getting the audience to shift the focus to watching it on television?
I think more than the pressure, I think just the, please, we, I think even though we have made it ourselves, I think the appreciation should be for the part that is in Hindi. I think that itself is a very, very big boon here because I do understand that, you know, accessing something in a language which perhaps everybody is not so well versed with and including the dialect and accent sometimes, we all have to still put on, at least I have to put on subtitles of English films till date. You know, sometimes you don't get the feeling because the language is new to you or not so, you're not so well versed with it. I think bringing it on Hindi, the spoken Hindi, Urdu, Hindi, Hindustani, jaise hum baat karte hain, Angrezi bhi mixed hai usme. I think that itself, more than it being challenging or wanting to be different, I think just the accessibility to a lot of people on television. And let me be honest, internet is fantastic. I think the digital world is growing. But television, especially Star and the Hindi-speaking programs on it, do reach a much larger audience in our country specifically. And to make that attempt on a general entertainment programming channel and put it out there, I think that's a very big step for a program like this. So I think it'll just have a lot of people. Our desire is, honestly, to get the people who haven't seen TED Talks, see it here. Then go to TEDTalks.com. Hear those talks also. Some of our talks may be present there too. But what I'd want is, I'm going to request Chris and Juliet to even subtitle those in Hindi and try to dub them in Hindi. I could do some of the dubbing for them. You know, it'll be very good for, I think, the people all across our country.
Thank you. Thank you. Main maafi chahta hoon, but please, due to time constraint, we'll have to call it a wrap. Thank you so much, everyone on the dais. Thank you so much.